Hey guys, I know you might be thinking that why I'm so much traditionally dressed today. Actually, as you all know, Diwali is coming soon, so happy Diwali for you in advance. And in today's video, I am going to tell you that how you can make this amazing DIY and learn to make some diyas for this Diwali. These are some decoration ideas for Diwali. So if you want to learn how to make it, make sure you watch the video till the end. In this video, we are going to make this amazing diya, and this is looking really pretty, guys. As you can see, it's looking like a lotus, and I just love it, guys. Like truly, it's just looking perfect, and it's simple, it's quick, and I just don't have some more words because I don't know. But this looks really, really pretty, guys. You should definitely try it out, and it's not expensive at all. You can make it using some stuff which is available at your home, and using some stuff you can buy it easily from the store. So let's start the video without wasting any time, and let's see how you can make this diya. And girls,
make sure when you make this diya, make sure to click pictures like this and send me on Instagram. Just a joke.
But if you want, you can also share your craft, your drawings on my Instagram. I will share it on my YouTube. So let's start the video without wasting any time, and let's start how you can make this DIY.
Subscribe now. Go down, scroll down, and just subscribe right now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, you are done. So let's start the video right now.
So now let's see what materials you will need to make this DIY. So here are some colorful candles, and here are the basic one. So you can use any one of this. And here I have some acrylic colors. These are metallic acrylic color. Let me give you a close-up look to this. So these are Fabrica's acrylic color, and it's of Camel company. You can use a normal acrylic color too, but I will recommend you to use acrylic color only. I will not tell you to use another color like poster colors or watercolors. So the next thing you are going to use is this glue gun. These are some plastic spoons. This spoon should be able to cut, and the last one is the scissor. I have two more materials, that is the tape, that is the sticky tape, and a cardboard. So let's start the procedure and let's see how you can make. So here I have this piece of cardboard. What I'm going to do is just cut a circle from this cardboard, which is going to be base of our candle. So for that, you will just take a radius, which will be for your circle. You can take radius of 5 cm, 10 cm. How much large you take the radius, your circle will be that much large, and your candle will be that much large, and you will need a lot of spoons for that. So here I'm going to take a small radius. You can use any radius you want. This is just a rough idea what I'm going to do. So here I have my circle cut out, and now I'm going to use it as my base for the candle. And for the edges, I'm going to use the tape, that is the sticky tape, and cover all the edges. So let me show you how you have to do it, by which all the edges which are rough right now of the cardboard will get sealed, and this will look beautiful and will make your candle look perfect. Now you will use this metallic acrylic color and paint the top of the color, like top of the spoon, with this color. You can use any color you want, and make sure to comment down your favorite color and let me know what's your favorite color. So as you can see, I'm just painting all over this spoon. You don't have to paint all the spoon, just the top of the spoon, because we are going to cut the extract of the spoon with a scissor. And I'm going to apply 2 coats of this paint, by which it will get some finishing, and that will make the product look more beautiful, more nice. So as you can see, I'm painting the second one. So we will paint like this for all spoon. So I'll see you after that. So as you can see guys, I have painted all the spoons and they are looking really beautiful with that shiny acrylic color. So this is the advantage of this color, that it looks really shiny and gives a glittery effect to the spoons. So now the next step is I will use a scissor and I will cut the top of the spoon. Make sure the paint is dry completely. Now as you can see, you have to just cut the top of the spoon. But guys, make sure if you are a kid and if you are making this, make sure you take help of an adult. And make sure you be careful, because it's a bit hard process for kids. So I'll complete all the spoons, like I will cut all the tips of the spoons, and let's see what we have to do next. So as you can see guys, I have cut all the spoons and they are looking like some petals. And here I have my base of this circle which we have made before. So I have this metallic blue color now. This is Persian blue color which I have got from the market, and it's acrylic metallic Persian blue color. So now what I'm going to do is paint the whole base, all the sides from the upside and from the down, and also the edges of it with this color. So let's just do that, because as I want all like total finishing to this DIY which we are making today, so I'm just going to be careful with the paint. And guys, I have a tip for you, that make sure you take something and down while painting all this stuff, as I have took this cardboard, because it will just make your setup, it will make your table messy. So for that, make sure you be careful. So let's just finish that and let's see what you have to do next. So guys, I am done with all painting stuff. Now it's time to stick the spoons to the base. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a glue gun and use the glue stick glue and stick all the spoons on the base. So this process I am going to show you properly, and as you can see, my hands are really messy right now. So that's a disadvantage, because I'm just trying to dry this. And guys, I know I'm looking like an idiot here, but I'm not patient guys, not at all. So I'm just going to dry it like this, because I'm really excited for this DIY, like how this will turn out, because I don't know, I'm really excited. So I'm just going to dry it like that and just placing my hand all over to see it, if it's dry. So I think it's dry. So let's now try to stick this on the base. So now here I have my glue gun, my spoons and my base. So now let's try to stick this with a glue gun. Guys, I will recommend you to use glue gun only, because it will help you to stick it more effectively, and it just works really good. Because if you stick it with a normal glue, it will not stay on the base, because like it will not stay. So you should definitely use a glue gun, and it works really amazing. So as you can see, I am done with sticking it over the base. Now it's time for sticking the candle with a glue gun. So I'm using a basic candle. You can use any colorful candle, but I'll prefer using this one. You have to just use a glue gun and stick it over. You can just normally put it, but I will prefer you to stick it on the top. So let's just do that and let's see our final product. So guys, this is how it's looking. I really love the results, and if you're trying it out, make sure to share it on my Instagram. Guys, I'm just obsessed with this DIY, and make sure guys to subscribe Shruti Arts and hit the like button, and also comment down what you think about this video, and make sure to share your results too. Make sure you subscribe, share, comment, and just love us, keep supporting me, and I'll see you in my next video.